Hello Stampers, welcome to another Rubber Redneck tutorial. Today I'm going to be demonstrating how to make this Halloween candy bar wrapper. This is the one I created using our Dark and Dreary stamp set. First thing you want to do is cut a piece of cardstock at 5 1/4 by 5 1/2. I chose our Cajun Craze, so again, cut a piece of cardstock at 5 1/4 by 5 1/2. Then you're going to want to score it. And I've already pre-scored it, so I'll just cover the scoring lines here. You want to score it at 1/4 inch, then at 2 1/2 inches, then at 2 3/4 inches, and then score at 5 inches. So again, you want to score at 1/4 inch, 2 1/2 inches, 2 3/4 of an inch, and 5 inches. I took our sanded background and I stamped on the Cajun Craze cardstock and Cajun Craze ink. Once you've got it scored, you're gonna wanna fold on your scored lines. Just take your bone folder and run that along. Again, take your bone folder, press down. And these measurements may vary on this type of candy bar you buy, the size. You'll just have to maybe adjust your measurements for your candy bar. But it should fit a standard candy bar. Then once I folded on the scored lines and everything here, you want to decorate. Do a little decorating on your candy bar before you put it, or candy bar wrapper before you put it together. I cut a piece of our designer series paper called Wicked Fun, and I cut this at 1 1/2 inches by 5 1/2. I sponged the edges with Cajun Craze ink, and I'm just going to add some snail right to the back of that. And then I placed that right in the center of one of my areas that will cover the front of the candy bar here. Then I took some of our 1/4 inch rich razzleberry grosgrain ribbon and I cut it to length to fit around the candy bar wrapper. And then I just took some glue dots to secure it like so. And then I took our dotted scallop ribbon border punch and punched out a piece of basic black cardstock, and then using the snail again, I just added it along the edges of the top of it so I could slide it in here under the ribbon. And by putting your ribbon on first, then you kind of have a border to line it up, line up your punched out piece here. And then I wanted to dress it up a little bit more, so I took some 1/2 inch black lace trim called Raven, and using the glue dots, I secured it again. And I just put that on the back there like that. I flipped it over, oops. Make sure you go up a little bit higher so your ribbon, your rich razzleberry ribbon shows there. And I just put it on there just at the top. And to save on the lace trim, I only cut just enough to decorate with. I didn't cut the full amount and waste it across the cardstock. Then to finish decorating it some more, I cut another piece of cardstock at 1 inch by 2 1/2 in Old Olive. And I sponged the edges with Old Olive ink, and then I took our matte pack and paper piercing tool and just added a little piercings down the sides here just to add a little more detail to the candy bar wrapper. And I placed stamping dimensionals on the back. And then we're going to place that right over the top like that in the center. And then I stamped our Happy Halloween from our Dark Endurer stamp set in basic black ink onto some Whisper White cardstock, and I cut it out, and then I sponged the edges with Rich Razzleberry, Cajun Craze, and Old Olive ink. I stamped the 31 and Cajun Craze, and I punched it out with our half-inch small circle punch, and I added some little black flourish jewels to the side here. And then I put dimensionals on the back of this piece. And then I just kind of placed that right in the center of the Old Olive. Now once you've done that, you're ready to wrap this around your candy bar. So I'm gonna lay that on there like this. And I added some sticky strip already on the inside of this quarter inch scored line. And then just press down like that. How fun and super easy is that if my ribbon stays on there? And it's a great way to dress up a candy bar for anybody. Thanks for watching.